Have you ever wondered how your next presentation can make a difference? How you can get yourself heard and get yourself noticed? In this episode, I will be teaching you how to create animated cover slide to kick off your show and maintain attention from your audience. Let's first take a look at the final version of the cover slide and how it will solve your challenges.
It starts with the black and white image of New York City, and then there are two sliders in the form of parallelogram that's sliding from the left with two different messages. And after that, as a third step, the black and white image becomes color image. Let's take a look at all of these things in more detail so you can see them happening. Our cover page slide animation starts with the black and white image of the New York City. Then the PowerPoint cover page animation message slides in. This is a blue parallelogram with the white text on it. Then the next step, tutorial by Vadim Mikhailenko, this is yellow smaller parallelogram slides in. And then as a last step, New York image from the black and white becomes color image. I wanted to mention that you can download the file if you don't want to watch the tutorial and just need the animated cover page. You can just go to description for this video, scroll down, and you will see the link to the tutorial. It would be on my website, so make sure to take advantage of this option. You don't necessarily need to go and do all the steps unless you want to learn how to do this animation. So you can just go ahead and download the tutorial and use it for your upcoming presentation.
Before we look at the details of making animated cover slide, let me explain what is the importance of the cover slide in general and why making your cover slide animated will make you successful in your presentation.
There are three important things to make your presentation successful. Number one is the content, and content is the message of what you're trying to deliver. Number two is the design of the presentation, visual appearance of what you're trying to say. And design also includes the flow. So what we're doing as part of this tutorial, we're looking how to make your design more appealing by adding animations into your design, which keeps audience more engaged and more interested in the content of what you're trying to present. And then number three is the delivery. And in the delivery, I'd like to emphasize the venue of how this presentation will be delivered. If you have opportunity, always try to deliver presentation in person. This way you can observe how people respond and how they react to what you're saying. Number two option is a phone conference. And sometimes, a lot of times actually, we all work remote, right? Or some people in our teams work remote. And for those people, the only way for you to contact them and share the message, share the content, would be attending the phone bridge and maybe presenting your screen. And then number three is email. Sometimes people just say, send me this presentation via email. I don't have a way of sitting down with you and looking at your content. So you want to make sure that your presentation is also positioned well for printing, because this person might be just looking at this, skipping all the animations, just printing the slides, and then reviewing the information you have to show. So why cover slide is so important to make your presentation a success? First of all, it captures the attention of the audience. Then it intrigues the people, right? If this person created such a cool cover slide, then its presentation is going to be extremely effective and successful, and there is a message I should listen to, which sets yourself for success going forward as part of this presentation.
By the way, creation of the main slide you're looking at here was covered as part of another YouTube tutorial. So make sure to check it out and also subscribe to my YouTube channel so you're not missing out on any other videos. So let's start this step-by-step tutorial. I'm going to run it twice. First on the fast forward, so you will see all intricacies in how to create the slide, and you will also better understand why we're doing things a certain way from the high level. And then we'll run the same tutorial at the regular speed, where I'll explain know-hows and the reasoning why I'm doing things a certain way.
The entire tutorial consists of the five main components. Component number one is downloading and installing and configuring the main background image. I provide lists to downloaded files, and I also share with you how to insert and configure it in PowerPoint. Step two of the tutorial is configuration of transitions for the background image. As you will see, we will create two copies of the same image. One would be black and white on top of the colored image. An ultimate transition for this tutorial is transition from black and white to color image. And the way it's accomplished is by black and white image disappearing and color image showing up. Then we're going to switch and add text boxes. One would be a large text box and then would be a small text box. And we will add a text to those text boxes, and we will also configure the animation.
Now let's review this tutorial with the regular playback speed now. This way I can explain you all the know-hows and why I did things certain way and why they should be done this way to help you make your presentation more engaging.
First, let's open up a new slide in PowerPoint. Then we would need to delete all extra elements that we will not be using. As a next step, we will click Insert tab and select Insert Pictures, and we will insert picture of New York City. I created a copy of the picture, but I also provide you a link. We also need to create a copy of the same picture and make a second picture black and white using these steps. First, we need to make sure second picture is selected. Then we select picture tools in the menu. Then we select color, select black and white, and then we realign second picture to make sure it's right on top of the first one. Keeping second picture selected, let's click Animations tab in PowerPoint. Then we add a new fade animation effect, and we'll want to make sure that we use fade and exit because there are two fade effects available. What we do then, we extend the duration of the default fade effect to make sure you can see gradual fading of black and white picture. Then we do a right mouse click on the fade effect and select effect options. Then we change duration of the effect, and I selected 3 seconds for the fade effect. Then we click preview button so you can see black and white picture fading and color picture appearing. Let's continue by adding flying text boxes in the form of parallelograms. Click Insert, Shape, and pick parallelogram. Next, type the desired text to the shape by selecting the shape and starting to type. Let's make font larger if necessary for better visibility and appearance. You can change background color of the shape to the color of your preference. Click on the shape and select properties, and then pick the desired color. Just wanted to take a quick interruption here and show you my advanced cover slide animation. This is the new tutorial I am working on, and make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you're not missing out when it's released. Let's continue. Now we will need to insert smaller shape, which could provide ability for you to insert additional text. Select Insert, Shape, and then parallelogram. Type the desired text, and then select background color of your choice. Keep in mind that if you have selected lighter background color as I did to add more contrast, you would need to change the color of the font as well to make sure font is visible. Next step is to create animations for parallelograms. First, click Animations pane and then fly in animation for the larger shape. Now let's change the order of the animation to make sure parallelograms animation gets triggered first before animations of the background image. Next, let's change the duration of the parallelograms animation. To do that, click Effect Properties, select Timing tab, and then select Duration equal to 2 seconds. Animation for parallelogram is triggered with the mouse click. We would like animation for the picture to be triggered right after parallelogram's animation has ended. To accomplish this, select Picture on Animation pane, do right mouse click, and then select Start with Previous. Now, let's change how parallelogram enters the slide during animation. By default, it enters from the bottom. Let's change the default behavior so it flies in from the left. To change the default animation behavior, select Parallelogram in Animation pane, do right mouse click, and then select Effect Options. Then change direction to fly from the left. Now let's add flying animation for the second parallelogram. Let's change the order for second parallelogram's animation to make sure it's executing right after the first one. Now let's make sure it also flies in from the left by selecting Effect Options and changing direction to fly from left. And then let's change duration for the animation to make it 2 seconds. After that, let's make sure second parallelogram's animation starts after the first parallelogram's one. We will do it by selecting smaller parallelogram in animation pane and using right mouse click, selecting Start After Previous option. And the last step is to preview the results of our hard work. Click Preview button and enjoy the show. Just to recap, we have completed the animation, which consists of 3 parts. 2 flying-in parallelograms and background, which changes from black and white into color.
Thanks for watching. Hope you've learned something and enjoyed this video. If you can, please share this information with somebody who might be working on the presentation right now and will benefit from this tutorial. Also, please share your comments and thoughts in the comment sections down below. I really review all of them and respond if opportunity permits, and of course if I know the answer. Also, if you like this video, please click that like button right there. This really helps me with my rankings. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.